So for Maya to stop suffer, and it's light because Maya got so dull and numb to ignorance and suffering that a little bit absence of pain is already pleasure. Means
That's for
that
sure.
means ah, so if I don't really suffer from the Maya point of view,
Milk.
then she's happy.
Yeah.
Yet this is the sages say, yay,
Be
be
careful.
careful. This is just absence of pain, so she's a little bit more is she's relieved.
She's
Relieved.
more
The
relaxed.
light is so dim there. Only when she moves, she thinking about you, she start to get the reflection, which is not even the light itself. Yet she start to become happier and happier. So, it just because of ignorance, this looks like she's there's no suffering. So, relationship is always painful. Relationship
Will you
is.
please get off the couch because you're causing
Relationship is always painful. What does it mean? It means when she is in ignorance, she has thoughts about the material world, that's always relationship. I leave the idea of people having relationship between each other. I'm not talking about that.
Yeah.
She's relating to objects, that's relationship. When she think about who I am, she's not in relationship because there's no separation. She thinks I am the Supreme Self. She's not the Supreme Self. Only she's using this thinking because she becomes happier, and that's what she's seeking. When she becomes happier and happier, that means I am reflecting the light upon her.
Oh,
I
so
am
that
witnessing
means.
her. I remain the witness, or the identity of who I am will return because the veil disappeared. So I'd like to talk about perceiving and perceived. Yes? As long as the perceiving, the perceiver, sorry, and the perceived, they appear simultaneously. So the ego, we start from
Yes, outside.
the gross veil, which is body veil, prana, ego, buddhi, and bliss. Yes, these are
Yes.
all the five coverings that cover the who I truly am. So when she is the perceiver of the perceived object, yes? So the object is perceived through the senses. Yes? The objects
Is perceived
perceived
through the
by the
senses.
are perceived through the senses.
Right.
Yes?
Yes.
So now there is no distinction between the perceiver and the perceived object.
No, there
They look
isn't.
identical. That means there is a veil there. Now, the witness is the perceiver and the mind is perceived. Yes?
Yes.
So now, even there is a veil. So the witness and the mind which is perceived look identical. That means false identity. So what happens when Maya is in ignorance? She is the perceiver of the perceived object, which is the first object, is the body.
Yes.
So she is identifying herself as a physical body.
Yes.
So, ego, senses, which is prana covering, and the world, which is the body, is jagat.
Yes.
This is all witnessed by you, the Supreme Self. What happens? Where is the prana there? The prana, so Maya project the ego, she moved in. She identifies herself as the ego. Now, the ego is using the senses. Inside the senses, the prana is perceiving. So we can see that if I use the analogy, ego is the perceiver, objects are the perceived, and the perceiving, which that which is perceiving the objects are the senses. So perceiving is due to prana. She's seeing, she's hearing, she's smelling, she's tasting, she's sense of touch, she's sensing. This is why the sages call the five organs of perception, five organs of knowledge, because the prana is seeing, is hearing. Yes? Prana is there, and she registers it in the memory.
Yes.
Without the prana, nothing can be heard, nothing can be seen, nothing can be registered. Now, prana is not the power that enables everything. Is you, the Supreme Self, which is the light, because the light illuminates the prana itself. The light illuminates Maya itself. Prana is just an instrument that Maya using. Maya is the cause of prana. Yes?
Oh, so nothing. So everything changes, but nothing changes.
So now, let's continue, so we'll stay in the same course. We're living the Maya, project the ego. She moved into the ego, and she's using the ego to go out through the senses to the external gross universe. So the sages called it external gross universe. So Maya would have the ability to distinguish between the gross external universe and then the material world in the subtle. That is actually where the ignorance is, where Maya ignorance, the ego is. Yes?
It's in the subtle world.
It's in the subtle world. Yeah. It is the subtle body. Yeah. So now we leave that and we go back from Brahma, from the source. She manifests the whole universe upon Brahma. She veiled the Brahma. Now, once she veiled it, it is the witness. Yeah? The witness is the same as Brahman. Yet now there is the first veiling. So
witness is Brahman veiled.
Veiled.
Yes.
Now, so it just reduced light. Now she projects the Buddhi. So once she projects the Buddhi, she veils the witness. That's the veiling of basically the fourth veiling. So there's no differentiation between the witness and the Buddhi. There's no differentiation between Maya, the thinker, and the witness. So Maya appears to be the witness. Yeah? When she's thinking about who you are, I am the Supreme Self, I am Supreme Knowledge, suddenly the witness hears her. It hears the truth, the identity, the veil is disappearing. The identity with the witness, which is you, remains. And there is Maya, she's thinking with no veiling. No veil there. Yeah? Now, let's say she's project the Buddhi, she veiled the witness, there is veil there, she's now, the Buddhi looks identical as the witness. She projects the ego, which means she moves more out. She veils the Buddhi and the witness. Now, from ignorance, Maya cannot differentiate between the Buddhi and the ego. She cannot differentiate between knowledge, light, and ignorance, darkness. She cannot, because there is a veil between the ego and the Buddhi.
Hence my question earlier.
So what happens? Only when she starts to hear the knowledge and she starts to think about the knowledge, because she's the thinker, she's using the Buddhi. She's using the Buddhi, the veil between the Buddhi and the ego disappears, because the differentiation is clear that Maya, the thinker who thinks about who you are, is different than the Maya who's thinking about the material world. Why? The Maya thinking about the material world appears to be a physical body. Maya, when she thinks about who I am, the Supreme Self, is seen to have no physical body.
She becomes a mental body.
She's subtle. She doesn't have a physical body. That means the identity with being a physical body, the veil falls away. So she is becoming freer because the body pulls her down into ignorance. The body pulls her down into darkness. So now she keeps thinking about you. She gets the reflection. So the veil, the veils of the gross body, gone. The veil of the prana is gone. And the veil of the prana is in the senses. The perceiving, yeah?
But we're in the subtle side.
So now it's gone. Now the veil between the ego and the Buddhi is gone.
Yes.
And the veil between the Buddhi and the witness is gone because you hear Maya thinking.
Yes.
When she goes into the meaning, she disappears. You, the witness, has nothing to witness. So you, the witness, is Brahman. This is how she returns. And she's so happy every time when she's going back to you. Yes?
Yes.
So the differentiations, the reason why Maya cannot differentiate is because the veils. Means if we'll lay, she cannot differentiate between the Buddhi and the witness. She cannot differentiate between the ego and the Buddhi. She cannot differentiate between the ego, the senses, and the physical gross body. Why? Because there is veil. So what the sages says, you have to shift the attention. Because Maya is in ignorance, you have to shift the attention to knowledge, means she's going to use the Buddhi. Then she can see the differentiation between the material world in the subtle and the Brahman world in the subtle. Once she stays in the Brahman world in the subtle, you witness her. When she's in ignorance, the ego, senses, and the body are synchronized. The differentiation cannot be distinguished. Cannot. So it cannot. That means the sages realize there in ignorance you cannot remove the veil. They're telling us there you cannot remove the veil. That means go to Maya knowledge, get her to use the Buddhi. With the Buddhi she will remove the veil between the Buddhi and the ego material world in the subtle world.